proclivity, yeah. Determination, laser focus, banging on they door, they taking notice, taking notice, taking notice. Determination, laser focus, banging on they door, they taking notice.
I just ran a checkup on myself. Some days I just have to check up on myself. I'm so icy, got that GG on my belt. Thank the Lord for my people and my health. Lost a lot, but I came out with no.
By many accounts, Coach, one of the most underrated home venues in all of the NFL resides in the heart of Nashville, Tennessee, and that's where we find ourselves at Nissan Stadium. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the New England Patriots and the Tennessee Titans. And he'll get it up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. This is Derrick Henry. And up to the 35 before they're able to knock him down. 13 yards is the pickup for Tennessee and a first down. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Derrick Henry. Tackle made by Devondre Campbell.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, this big defensive lineman will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
On second down, here's Henry. To the 40 and no further. The broken tackle, but then the hole closed quickly.
One thing to keep in mind, partner, especially in the second half, when you've got a running back of this size and these dimensions, I can just tell you, attrition does set in for a defense because you're excited about hitting him in the first half. Maybe not so much in the second half, and some of these shorter gains turn into bigger runs later.
And he finds his target. It's Sharp. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. An 11-yard pickup for the Titans and a first down. So into Pat's territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 49-yard line. Henry. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable second down. A very solid gain on that play.
On second down. It's Henry. He'll get only a couple down to the 44.
Well, so many times we look at a short run and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things. But the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. It wasn't a big run given up. They don't always have to absorb the body blow. Sometimes they dish them out themselves.
From the gun on third down, Rodgers. And he's going to be hit and taken down. Back right around the 48-yard line.
It always helps for a visiting team to come in and set the tone on defense. In fact, when we talked with them prior to the game, they said they wanted this home crowd to feel like they had to hide their valuables when they were in town.
Well, the home crowd quiet now early. See if their offense can take over and get some points on the board.
On fourth down, here's Brett Kern to punt the football away. Back deep, Antonio Brown. He was called on 3 times in the win last week as his first one here's away. So they will accept the penalty and move forward.
On the double.
53 is the mark.
Pilot, 64. We go.
Kill, kill, kill.
Hey, lock it.
Kill.
Get it ready.
They'll run for the first time with Sony Michel. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice solid gain. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there.
Second down, Stidham to throw. Philip Dorsett hauls it in. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled.
But it appears that they read man defense and went to the out route, and what you have to do on that one is the receiver's got to make sure he works the defender towards the middle of the field to give himself space to cut to the outside and have that ball delivered with good timing, and they got it done.
Now a first down carry. It's Michelle. He's got the first down and more inside the 40. And they'll halt things here for an injury, and that looks to be Sony Michelle who's down. While the training staff takes a peek, we'll take a break. So operating from Tennessee territory now, here's first and 10 at the 35-yard line. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9.
Well, we saw him there trying to get it to the outside, trying to get to the perimeter, but not a whole lot of room there. But there's got to be one positive to that. If you keep moving laterally, creases tend to develop as the game moves on, and they can run it back inside later.
The run only got a yard. Here's second and 9.
Hey, pick your game up. Greystone, travel. Hey, exit. 53, come on. 53, check 53. Hey, let's go.
Come.
Let's go, let's go. Hey, we got Mike, number 53.
61, match box, right. Let's go.
Now Stidham on second down. And a dump off to White. It'll be a gain of 6, and that's going to lead to a third down.
Charles, Thursday night game, I think a lot of teams probably say shrink the playbook somewhat. Is that correct?
I think you're right about that because you just don't have the amount of time that you have in a normal week to put in a full playbook. So, as you said, you shrink the playbook, pick out the plays that work best for you. You know what else you're looking for?
What's that?
Who are the freshest guys coming off of the last game to play on a Thursday night? Guys have a little extra pep in their step. You go to them early and often.
The field goal unit's going to stay put on the sideline. They're going to go on fourth down here. Fourth down. Here's Stidham. And that is going to be incomplete. The Patriots come up empty on fourth down. And as a result, it'll be Titan football on the turnover on downs. Tennessee offense about set and ready to go and hoping to do better than they did their last possession when they punted the football.
Appeal to the vanity of your offensive line. Tell them that they control your fate. Leverage guys. Win the line of scrimmage. If you do that, you start to win first down. You win second down. And guess what? You start accumulating first downs. And that's what they need in order to not punt the ball again.
It's first and 10, a big mistake, especially when you factor in the personal foul yardage. After the penalty, it's Henry. And he'll push this forward only to about the 42-yard line. A minimal gain as we tick down inside of a minute remaining in the opening quarter.
Nice job by that defensive front there to hold him to a short gain on first down. Well played, I must say.
Yeah, only getting 1 yard. There was no room to run.
Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run. Give him 6 yards on the carry. It's going to be 3rd and 3 now.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent game.
Brings up 3rd and 3.
No, no,
And this will probably be the last play of the quarter.
Watch the pass. Watch the pass.
That's the end of the first quarter with no score.
158.
Rodgers going to try and throw on third down. That is caught. It's Tajay Sharp. And he's got another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Patriots' 38-yard line. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Running from the gun with Henry. He'll be hit down at the 33, 5 yards on the play.
Partner, I think from our experience together, we have learned that most offensive coordinators are going to tell you, if I'm going to run the football on first down, I've got to get at least 4 yards. They got five here. They've got to feel pretty good about that one.
And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage.
I know when I was a kid, I always got real excited when I saw those lateral-type runs. But the best backs that made it happen, they put a foot in the ground and just go. That didn't happen there. That play got swallowed up.
The Titans on third down. They've been okay. 2 for 3 thus far. This will be 3rd and 6. Shotgun now for Rodgers. He gets it to Brown. Complete. And they just keep marching right along. First down on a pickup of 8 there.
As an unbiased observer, I think it would have been interesting to see what they would have done if they hadn't gotten the first down there. But since they did, I guess the point is moot.
Yeah, they're right there in that middle ground, field goal range, punt, go for it. But as you said, they picked it up.
Now Rodgers. It's caught. Michael Pruitt. 5 yards on the catch there. Brings up 2nd down.
And partner, I think that's a great example that not all tight ends are created equal. Because everything was right. Got the completion. But he's not one of the more dynamic guys in the league. So even though he caught it, couldn't turn it into much more.
Throwing again on 2nd down, but this time it's incomplete. The intended receiver that time, Adam Humphries. And that takes us from 2nd to 3rd down. And again, it's Rodgers. And this is going to be caught by Sharp for a Tennessee touchdown. Tajay Sharp, his first touchdown on the year, as his guys are on the board first here tonight. Extra point up and good by Succop. And it's now a 7-0 game. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback.
Let's go.
The Pats at the line, ready to go. And on the last drive, they were in field goal range. They just opted not to kick it, didn't get it. How does that change the mentality this go around?
I don't think it changes much for the head coach, because this is what he preaches all the time. Attack at all times in any spot on the field. And he likes touchdowns, not field goals. Now, your field goal kicker, you've got to make sure you nurse him through and say, okay, don't worry about it. When we need you, you've got to be ready to go. And the team, of course, loves to see points on the board. So let's see if it changes a little bit for in the same spot again.
Well, we'll see what the decision is here if they get to that spot. On first down, Stidham. It's complete. James White. And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45. A 10-yard pickup, and it's enough for a Patriot first down. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down.
Hey, watch the slant. Hard, hard. Slant, slant, slant.
First down, here's White. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be 2nd and 8.
Doubling this guy has to be a priority before moving up to the next level, because the big fella, he just ate that one alive, just stuffed it. In fact, before the game, he was talking to us, and he's like, hey, these pants make me look fat. And we said, nah, man, you're just a whole lot of guy.
He is at well over 300 pounds. He's a big man.
Hey, Jet.
On second down, here's Stidham. Dorsett's got it. That catch good for five. It's third down.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
Got it.
A good chance. This is four down territory if they're unable to convert. But right now, looking at a third and three. Stidham now to throw on third down. Got his man. That's Harry. And he picks up the first before he's taken down at the 29. What a methodical drive this is turning out to be. That time 9 yards, and the sticks move again. They don't need to run another play here before the two-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. First carry for Damian Harris, the Alabama man. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to second and four.
Get it, boys! Get it, boys!
It's a pickup of six. Brings up second.
2 minutes on the clock, second quarter, 7-0 ball game. Coming up at the half, a reminder, we go back to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman. He'll have a look back at our first half, as well as a look ahead to what's coming up later this weekend. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. He'll wind up losing a yard on the play, and that'll bring up a third down.
Go! 50 plants and Alpha! Hey.
On third down, Stidham. And he's going to have the hookup here with Harry. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Titans' 13-yard line.
A gain of 12. First down, New England.
Ready.
53.
General West.
Watch his flat. 53, come on. 52. Here we go, G, get off the field. Let's go.
Now flags come in. Look like one of the Patriots might have moved. The false start backs him up five. First and 15. Here's Stidham. This is White on the screen. That's a gain of 11. Would have been a first down if not for that penalty moments ago.
When you run a screen pass really well, you got to like the look of it, because so many parts come together to make it work well. The offensive linemen, where they're faking people out, the back slipping out there, catching the football, then all of them going together as one unit downfield, a really nice pickup.
Now it's Stidham. And that's going to be caught for a Patriot touchdown. N'Keal Harry, his third touchdown now on the year, as they are now on the board here in the first half. Extra point good by Gaskowski, and that is going to tie our game as we approach halftime. So all even at seven now as they kick it away. This will be fielded at the 8. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line.
At their own 28-yard line.
The Titans' offense set to begin the drive. And we're under a minute to go here. What's been an even first half, all tied up.
Yeah, still time to make something happen, too. Couple completions, you string them together. Could get into field goal range. Let's see what happens.
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete. Tajay Sharp, the intended receiver. And that'll bring up second down.
It's been my observation. There's been a nice variety of play calling defensively. You and I often talk about an offense's ability to keep a defense off balance with what they're doing. I think the converse has been true in this game.
Yeah, I think you're right. They seem to have gone off tendency quite a bit, but only the second quarter, a lot of time to change things. Another throw on second down, and this one incomplete as well.
Oh, man, that was close. The opportunity to change momentum, big play, right in his hands, unable to come down with it.
A sigh of relief, no doubt, on offense that that fell harmlessly to the ground. Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. Shotgun now for Rodgers. And brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line. 17 yards on that play for the Titans. The Titans going to use the first of their timeouts as they stop it with 19 seconds to go in half number one. And 10. Here's Rodgers. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Now Tennessee going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 13 seconds to play in half number one. Work to be done here on second and 16 after the sack. Here's Rodgers. And he will find his big tight end over the middle. And he'll be brought down somewhat awkwardly here, and a late flag as well. I think this one's going to be a face mask. The penalty moves him into the red zone here on first and 10. Working from the gun, Rodgers. Looking in zone, but it's incomplete.
Incomplete in the end zone. He was covered by Stephon Gilmore.
So with 4 seconds to go in the half, here's the field goal unit onto the field. From the right hash, just a 34-yard attempt. And the 12-year veteran knocks it right through, and that will do it for this first half. So we've hit halftime, just a field goal separating these two teams at the break. As we send you down to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman has our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach, both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. This will be fielded at the 8. And he'll be brought down at the 23, make it the 24-yard line. The Pats at the line, ready to go. They're close, close game, but they're going to need to do a little bit better probably here in half two, no?
I would agree with that totally. I would guess that in the locker room, they talked about cleaning up some of the errors, but overall, I think they wanted to be positive with them. Guys, we're right there, just not playing as well as we need to. Let's pick it up, and we still have a chance to win this game.
Yeah, they do. We'll see if they can pick it up. The run got 4. Now they deal with a 2nd and 6. Stidham. Dorsett making the catch. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. That'll be a New England first down, a gain of 12. They'll run on first down. White. And they get to him after a gain of 6 to the 46.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
Go, go. 53 at the mic. Let's go. 53 at the mic. All right, you draw a quarter.
second down, Stidham to throw. And this is going to be incomplete. The tight end Cameron Brait was the target, and it'll bring up third down. How about the defensive effort from both of these teams that we've seen in this game?
Would you say it's like a high-stakes chess match right now?
Chess is one way to go.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, I like it.
Okay, the only reason I say that, you feel like they're contemplating their moves before actually making one, and none of them being done very confidently.
Truth be told, I've never played chess, and I know that I'm not smart enough to play chess. Guys like you with your IQ, pull that off. Now they face a third down and four after that incompletion on second down. They snap it at one. Now Stidham. And able to find Dorsett. And they're well past midfield, just a yard or two shy of the 40. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Titans' 41-yard line. So operating from Tennessee territory now, here's first and 10 at the 41.
Switch. Check 26.
Running out of the gun with White. And they're able to swarm him behind the line, and his rough night continues. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. Now, they struggled to get him rolling on the ground in the first half, and that's sort of continuing here in the third quarter.
Yeah, but I don't think it's time to abandon the running game. I would say keep feeding the horse, and I believe he'll eventually reward them, especially as we get deeper in the game.
Yeah.
Mike, 53. Mike.
I'm coming after you.
Pilot, 64. Weak.
And with the play clock at 5, we're going to get a timeout. It's just their first, so 2 remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter.
You ready?
53.
Hey, dude.
Now Stidham on second down. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on third down.
Didn't have a receiver open downfield, and as it turned out, couldn't even find his outlet, man, because of the coverage. It was way too tight. Unable to find anyone open.
Big play coming up. Here's third and 10.
I would expect to see some pressure here.
The pressure drops off as they'll look to throw. Oh, he can't hang on to it. Almost intercepted. They would have loved the first pick of the game there, but at least it does get them to fourth. Down. So now they're going to send out the field goal unit to, as they say, fire away from long distance. They'll spot it at the 47, so call it a 57-yard attempt. And this is good from 57 yards out. That was bombs away right there. So they come away from this opening drive of the third quarter with only 3, but it does draw them even.
Yeah, and that has to be job one, doesn't it? A touchdown definitely would have been nice. We know that. But here, you get back on even terms, and now you've got most of the second half to try and get yourself into a position to win.
So all square here in this third quarter as the kick's away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. Tennessee offense about set and ready to go. Their defense has done the job. Now it's the offense's turn as they've got it first and 10. They'll try and get the run game going. This is Henry. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. It's a loss of 2 there, bringing up second down.
I think it's pretty evident. We can say what a difference a week makes. Last week, he ran pretty much wild, didn't he? Did pretty much what he wanted to do. But this one, they stopped him cold. That, to me, that's good scouting and even better execution.
Yeah, and they stopped him behind the line right there. They obviously watched the tape a few times and made some adjustments.
A nice job there as he rumbles for nine, and it'll be back to a third and three. Rodgers going to try and throw on third down. The hitter here is complete. And he will have first down yardage as he's brought down at the 41. That gain of nine buys them a new set of downs. On play action. Now Rodgers. This will be caught by Brown. And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45.
So much goes into a successful play, doesn't it? How about that play action there, freezing the defense just enough to bring the tight end free downfield for the completion.
And very little running room there. He did get a couple up to the 49.
You know that old expression, it's not my night? It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
Every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. And Henry fighting for the marker, but I don't think he got there. He did not. Here's Brett Kern now. And surprisingly, this is the first punt of the game for either team. He gets it away, and I think they'll smartly play keep away here from Brown. The Pats at the line, ready to go. And fortunate to get points on the board last time. They had to get a really long field goal to do so.
The kickers in today's game are so good and so skilled and hit from distances that we almost start to take them for granted. And we can't do that. That's a long field goal that they got 3 points out of. They've got to feel good about that. And they better make sure they love him up because he's helped them out.
Yeah, now we'll see if that offense can put six on the board here. We'll see. Now flags come in. Looked like one of the Patriots might have moved. And that false start penalty is certainly not helping their cause here. Second down and long.
Hey, Foxtrot.
Out of the gun, Stidham. He's going to air it out for Dorsett. And that will be incomplete. Tried to dial up the long way out there, but it'll be third down.
I remember Philip Dorsett coming out of the University of Miami ready to hit the league. All we talked about was speed, speed, speed. Just throw it to him. And you've got a great chance at a completion, but not that time.
Not that time. They tried a deep downfield with his speed, but incomplete.
Hey, my seven.
Hey, we got Mike, number 53. Mike, 53. Don't get nervous.
Chris on travel.
Third and long. It's Stidham. In a heavy trap. And now a fumble. The ball's out. And I think they are going to get this one back. Well, that would have been something. Double turnovers. But instead, they'll keep the possession on the INT. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10.
Hey, team six. Team six.
Check, 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 check. He's coming. He's coming. He's coming.
He's coming. He's coming.
They will run with White out of the shotgun. And he takes this up right near the 45-yard line. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it second and four. The last run got six, now second and four.
I can't believe they let you play. I can't believe they let you play.
Leo, Leo.
They keep it on the ground, White again. And he'll be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
A gain of 4 yards. And the Patriot first down.
One quarter remains here in this Thursday night matchup. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports.
Hey, hey, Lord.
They go play action now. Stidham. He's going to float this one deep right side. And that will be incomplete.
Would have been a big hitter if they had connected. Instead, it's second down. Those passes out that far wide always make you hold your breath a little bit. Felt like it was in the air for a while.
What it does is allows a defender to gain some ground, come from a long distance, and have a chance to affect the pass.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and ten.
Here we go.
61, matchbox lights.
Again on second and ten, it's Stidham. And break, the tight end's got it. And this will be stopped at the 44. That one good for 7 yards. The reception good for seven. It's third down.
Let's not quibble about the game there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take-what-you-can-get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now it gives them a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
New England on third down. They've converted 3 out of 5 thus far. Here it's third and three.
Mike, 53. 53. Mike,
go.
Stidham, third down from the gun. Looks to throw, fires right side. And that's going to be incomplete. The coverage too good there. The contact popped the ball free, and it's fourth down. Tie game, fourth quarter, and they're going for this thing on fourth down. They'll try and throw for it with Stidham. A little too aggressive defensively, and the flag comes out.
And no one trying to cover is going to like a call going against them, but you have to like the effort there. Went for the interception, just unable to get it, and the flag did come out.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Stidham sets to throw on first. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. And he's taken down inside the 30. A 10-yard pickup, and it's enough for a Patriot first down.
They ran that one well, and not only did they pick up a nice chunk of yardage on the screen, they sent a message to the defense. Rush the passer all you want, but you better be careful. We can hit you going back the other direction.
70, Indy.
I'm coming for the son. I'm coming for the son.
Watch the air.
Hey, Charlie.
On first and 10, it's Stidham. He gets it complete to Harris. That was play number 7 on this drive, and it got him 7 yards.
It's funny, throughout the time that we've been together, when we talk with running backs about the ability to catch the ball, their eyes light up when they talk about open field and having one-on-one matchups, don't they?
Yeah, they do. And that's the reason why we just saw shedding those tackles, and that's what they're used to doing.
It is, and it starts at the beginning of the play, one-on-one matchup of someone trying to cover them, but they also like those one-on-ones downfield after the catch when they're running with the ball. They think they're going to win those, too.
New England on third down. They've hit it 50%, 3 of 6 to this point. They're up against a 3rd-and-1 situation. They stay on the ground with White. And he's going to have a first down here as he gets this one to the 17-yard line. Got what he needed for the first down with a gain of 2.
First down, Patriots.
Ready, ready. 90, Wolf. Roll out.
On first down, it's White, and he'll be stopped after a gain of only a couple down to the 15-yard line.
I like the call. Inside the red zone, running the toss. Why? They want to get to the edges. They want to see if guys who don't normally make a lot of tackles are willing to actually do that. That usually means the guys in the cornerback position.
The last run good for 2. Here's 2nd and 8.
Let's get off the field.
Go.
On 2nd down, this is Harris. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. It's a loss of 2. Now 3rd down. That was shades of Tennessee Volunteer football back in the 80s with Charles Davis coming up from the secondary to make the tackle for a loss.
You mean my teammates doing that, right? Because they would tell you, my coach would say, where's that tape? I want to see that. But how about the complete package there? Not just playing the pass, but being a willing tackler and making a really nice play.
Got a man open. That's Harry. It'll be a gain of 8, but it'll also lead to a 4th down. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it. So it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
So the drive here ends with a field goal. It does give them the lead, but this one's still certainly a long ways from over.
It definitely puts a lot of pressure on your defense to hold the lead, right? They're happy to have it and happy to be out there trying to do so. But I know as a former player, in the back of their mind, they're thinking, why don't you score the touchdown and seal this thing?
The Titans offense set to begin the drive. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now with the game this close, you got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
On first down, Rodgers. Looking for his tight end on the corner. It's complete. Tennessee getting the first down on a big play of 18 yards. 3 points separating these two sides with 2 minutes left to go in the fourth. So the Titans in possession of the football here as we get your reset. They come up on a first and 10, desperately needing a score here on what could be their final drive. Rodgers to throw. He's got his man Sharp complete. First down, Titans, gain of 12. Rodgers now 11 of 15 through the air. Here's first and 10. Now it's Henry. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down. Now the Patriots will use the second of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. The last run got a couple. Here's second and 8. Back to throw, Rodgers. And his throw here's incomplete. He was unable to complete it there, and just not the game that you would expect from him. He's been off the mark, really, start to finish.
Yeah, it makes you wonder what exactly is going on. Is he a little bit dinged up here? Or is he just off just by a bit? Maybe he can get it back in this situation. He'll need to.
To throw is Rodgers. And nearly intercepted there. That would have been ball game if he had clinched it and caught it. Instead, it gives him one more chance here on fourth down. So the field goal unit is on the field as this is a big spot right here. He connected on his first, this from 41. Suckup's kick is good. And we are all tied here in the final stages. Now, we knew this had the potential to be a tight game, but with less than 3 minutes to play, couldn't be any tighter. We're all tied.
All locked up, right? And this next drive's going to tell us everything we need to know about this game because I want to see how they come out with the football. Are they going to be aggressive and attack downfield? You still got the 2 minute warning to come up. Or are they going to be conservative and try and hold on and maybe just get to overtime?
On the ready. The Pats at the line, ready to go. They've got work to do, but they do still have a bit of time here.
And they've got to feel comfortable with that. But they have all their play sequences called. If they get out of bounds, that allows them to huddle and call another play. But if they don't, it's hurry up to the line of scrimmage and either spike it and stop the clock or continue to move it downfield in order to try and get in range and win this game.
See if they can do just that. He's going deep, and this is going to be intercepted. Picked by Kevin Byard, and his guys are going to take over at the 34-yard line. Tennessee offense about set and ready to go. They need to get this around the 40 on the other side to get into field goal range. Look at the clock, a decent amount of time here in a tie game. What do they do?
No panic situation at all. They've got to get a couple of chunk plays, pick up nice bits of yardage.
Target the sidelines.
Target the sidelines because you want to get out of bounds and make sure that clock stops. Because if the clock stays running, that makes things that much tougher for you. It can always bleed out on you.
From midfield, here's Rodgers. And that'll wind up incomplete. Trying to give his man room to run under it, but it's second down. I guess you can't be afraid to take those chances late in the game. He tried to fit that one in there. Nice job, though, defensively.
But to your point, it was a nice job of knocking the ball away. But you're also right. You can't be afraid to take those chances. That means your guys going downfield to catch the ball, they've got to elevate their game and come down with these in order to keep your offense moving.
To throw once more on second and 10. Rodgers, he's got it complete. Derrick Henry. And he's got another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Patriots' 34-yard line. The Titans going to use the first of their timeouts as it'll come with 36 seconds to go in half number two. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. And the busy night for Henry continues. And a short gain down to about the 33. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9. They'll run it again with Henry. Call it an 8-yard gain. Much better shape now on third and just a yard. Now the timeout will be called, so they're in field goal range with 3 seconds left. On now is Ryan Succop for the field goal try. With 3 seconds to go, this for the win. And a timeout comes in. The whistles blow with 3 seconds remaining. On now is Ryan Succop for the field goal try. With 3 seconds to go, this for the win. And his kick is good. He knocks through his third field goal of the game, and this one is the one that decides it. And the Titans are going to win the football game. Well, a little drama there at the end, but really this thing was already decided. The late points get scored, and then it ends on the kickoff.
And I'm right there with you, partner. At the end of the game, they knew what they had to do. Just make sure you don't cough up the football at the end. Just take care of it, and victory was theirs, and that's exactly what they did.
So for Tennessee, it may not be too late to salvage their season as the win moves them to 2-5 now on the year. And they'll get another home date next week as the 49ers will come to town. Meanwhile, for New England, the losses are piling up as they drop to 1-5 now. And they'll try again next week at home against New England. And for Charles Davis and our entire crew here at EA Sports, I'm Brandon Gordon saying so long, everybody.
Yeah.